Oh, hi. Hello, John. How are you?
I didn't know about the twink vaccine. Is that who's that for? Is that for Travis? I didn't.
Tweak. They tweaked. Twink.
What?
They
maybe
tweaked.
20 years ago.
They tweaked.
Twinks need to be safe too. Twinks need to. I mean, it's not just for trolls.
John, no. No. Tweaked. Okay.
Oh,
but even
tweaked.
The original shot. Oh. That's exciting. Even the original shot.
Sorry, Travis. I'm in a totally different fetish group. I apologize.
It's okay.
Yeah,
but thank you for making me about 20 years younger than I am.
By the way,
hey Travis, let me tell you, I live in New York City, okay? In Chelsea, I'm already a troll, but in the village, I'm still a twink. So it's beautiful. It can work out.
There you go. There is life.
Do you still take your cat for a walk in a baby stroller? Are you
that straight guy
in the village?
No, that cat died a while ago, and I have a wee backyard, so the cat I have now doesn't need it. But I am a big proponent of cat strollers. Yes, if you live in a city, keep that thing sane and get it out and get it some stimulation and calm it the hell down for the rest of the week.
That is
also Stephanie. I love your mother. Mm-hmm. I traveled back and forth many times. I was doing every week for years and years. There's this thing they have called Cars and Roads, and here's how it works. You take a car
6,000 miles. I don't think so.
Down to the 10.
I only have a week 6, off.
6,000 miles. It's 3,000. You take a car down to the 10 freeway. You make
it's
a left.
6,000.
And you take that all the way to I-95.
6,000.
And then you take another left, and then you see your mom. It takes about 3 days if you have a companion.
Yes, I have a week off. Okay. Thank you, John, for that. Listen, I just want to say it does take a man very secure in his own masculinity to take a cat in a stroller in Greenwich Village. But, okay.
It takes a man secure in his masculinity to grow his hair this long and wear glasses so I resemble Fran Lebowitz. That's secure.
Your hair has gotten distinctly more Jesus-y as COVID has progressed, I notice. You really are my personal comedy Jesus now.
Is that the longest it's been ever?
What's that?
Is that the longest your hair has been ever?
Maybe it is. Huh. You know, my wife was trying to figure it out. It was a lot longer when I was younger, but like I told you, I was going for John Wick during a Moroccan oil shortage. That was the look I was going for. And
it's all hot. It's all. Can I just tell you, after last week, some listener, Killjoy blockers, like, stop with the sexually harassing John Fugel saying it's getting old. I'm like, not for me.
Can just, just kiss
my ass. I'm not going to stop. Okay. That's
how Donald Trump says it too. Not old for him yet. So yeah, thank you. I enjoy being a piece of meat in your eyes.
Thank you. Listen, you haven't had to endure John Fugelsang in person and the magnificence for year after year.
Oh, I cut so I can feel. So I'm signing up for all of it.
Yeah.
So yeah.
I just hey listener blocker, you can suck my okay. Listen, John, you This is why John Fugelsang is so hot, because he tweeted, we've waited 20 years to see a Cheney punished for lying, and instead we get a Cheney punished for not lying. It's really the irony.
That's a long wait. I mean,
you would have thought lying us into war, but no.
And we're finally seeing Mitt Romney booed by Republicans, but not for being an evil vulture capitalist, but because he told the truth about something. It's really amazing. We found their red line. Hmm?
Yeah.
If I see one more liberal defending Liz Cheney, it's like, go ahead and defend her on this, but let's not pretend Liz Cheney hasn't been an awful person for many, many years.
Exactly.
But we have gone 18 years. We have gone from Dick Cheney killing a million people for a lie to Liz Cheney killing her own career for the truth.
Yeah.
That's where America's at right now.
John, I often think what my dad or Coldwater would think of this. It's not even a partisan thing. They're just lunatics.
No.
They're just lunatic conspiracy theorists. And it's even, you sort of alluded to it, even their core principles, like fiscal conservatism. You said blaming Joe Biden for the deficit is like blaming your hangover on the guy making breakfast. I mean, it's just, they just don't have any credibility, even as, that was their core principle, right? Was fiscal conservatism.
Yeah, John Meacham is on my show tonight, and we taped it yesterday. And he has a new podcast called "The Fate of Fact," and it's all about how the GOP became this party that could be lied to and so marginalized, and how did they become like this conservative party
with a white nationalist conspiracy fringe to a white nationalist conspiracy party with a conservative fringe. It's fascinating. He traces it back to World War II. And when the guy who started the John Birch Society, who was a candy maker, Welch, began saying that Eisenhower was a communist puppet, that the Supreme Allied Commander was a communist puppet. But it worked enough that he began the John Birch Society, and it's a straight line right to where we are right now, where a lot of our right-wing loved ones just want a big, strong orange man to lie to them. And that's it. It's all about the dopamine squirt.
Yeah.
But they like it. Can you say it's a bad lie? What do you do when the people who are being lied to are signing up for it because they enjoy how the lies make them feel?
Yeah. John Meacham was on our show as well a couple of weeks ago, but that's history now.
Oh, sorry. I almost got thoughtful and introspective for a second.
Anyway, tune into John's show on Sirius. It's always fantastic. John is a fantastic guest.
Stephanie already had my guest weeks ago and made scrotum jokes. You've already missed it. It's over. It's way
better. He enjoys a good scrotum joke. Are you kidding me?
Don't we all?
All right. Just listen, go balls out in that interview. So, John.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, look at you.
So, as you know, it was hard to pick a favorite John Fugelsang sketch from Sexy Liberal Anniversary Show. What's the matter?
I have
to say Tucker Carlson's baffled bolt face was my favorite. Your Tucker Carlson was. But you and I live, obviously, by the First Amendment. We have our own radio shows. Tucker Carlson is awfully on the line of fire in a crowded theater for me in terms of the amount of people he's killing with dangerous misinformation, right? This latest thing. I mean, and again, it's just every night now. This is just whatever last night. Mm-hmm. I don't know, Travis, is it last night or two nights ago? So he just, we are at such a critical tipping point, as you know, John, with, you know, vaccines and the variants and we are literally at this tipping point. So Carlson, who has simultaneously peddled anti-vaccine fear-mongering while alleging he's pro-vaccine, misused data to claim people were dying from shots at a rate not even close to normal. He said, how many Americans have died after taking the COVID vaccine, he asked, as he provided numbers from the Vaccine Adverse Events Reporting System, is what it's called, VAERS. Database allows, first of all, anyone to submit a report for any reason. One doctor said if you had a vaccine today, then had a heart attack unrelated to the vaccine, your death would be in VAERS. Vaccinating hundreds of millions of people means that by random probability, some people will die, and it has no relationship to the vaccine. That is simple math.
Right.
Tucker, being an idiot, he writes, took that number of deaths and says they're related to the vaccine. This, of course, is nonsense. So, of course, he took a bitch slapping all over Twitter.
Tucker's not an idiot either. I mean, Tucker's profoundly ignorant, and he's long-term stupid, but short-term, he's idiot like a fox. Look, Tucker spent his entire life wanting to be liked. He spent his entire life trying to make old white men love him as a little National Review, little William F. Buckley in training. I love that his yearbook picture came out, and it showed that he was in the Dan White Society.
Yeah.
Celebrating the man who murdered Harvey Milk.
Yes.
And that he was such a huge fan at such a young age of an incredible racist like Strom Thurmond. This is all you need to know about Tucker. These Bubba the Love Sponge tapes should be distributed everywhere so every old person can hear just how Tucker thinks about women. But here's the thing. Tucker tried Crossfire. He tried being a journalist. He tried Dancing with the Stars. He finally realized the way to get ahead in this world is to lie to old white racist people who want to be lied to. The only question anyone should be asking Tucker, and he should be asked this every time he goes out in public, have you been vaccinated?
Yeah.
Have you been vaccinated? Why don't we know if Tucker's actually had the shot yet? Rupert Murdoch was able to get his vaccine before the Queen of England was able to get her vaccine. And Rupert takes money every day by letting this sycophantic little quizzling go on the air and sow doubts about the vaccine. I mean, this is worse than Hannity and the birtherism because people are directly going to die from it.
Well,
I think America, I'm serious. We deserve to know, has Tucker been vaccinated? How deep?
I'm sure
is
he
his
has.
Capacity?
Yeah. I mean, I'm glad people on Twitter were on this. You know, Tim tweeted, Tucker Carlson will cause people to die of COVID. All for the sake of his ratings. There is nothing more to say about such dishonest, outright sociopathy. I mean, that's what it is. Someone else tweeted, David tweeted, this is just remarkably deceptive and he knows it. Does it even need to be said? Died after is not the same as died because. And there is zero research to support the idea that thousands of Americans he's talking about died because of the vaccine. I mean, John, obviously they vaccinated the elderly and sick first. So of course a percentage of people, but this is so dangerous. I mean, when is it in your opinion, fire in a crowded theater? I mean, you're pointing
right
out
now, when Donald Trump is president and you're literally telling everyone's grandma to go fill the church pews on Easter Sunday, while privately telling Bob Woodward, you know, it's a dangerous, deadly airborne pathogen. Okay. Like it's just flat out murder. And it's like when we're seeing this war between the Cheneys and the Trumps, where both sides are responsible for so much death and suffering. 1 million Iraqis under Cheney, 500,000 Americans under Trump, because they think that 90% of our deaths could have been prevented. So it's way beyond that point, but like, this is how it works. And Tucker's white supremacy is more obvious than ever. His misogyny is more obvious than ever. But at the core of it, he's a pure Trumper. He should run for president for the Republican Party because their only value, the only thing they believe in, is selfishness as a virtue.
Yeah.
That's it. That's all the Republican Party stands for. Selfishness is a good thing, blind obedience to Trump, and owning the libs. Those are the three pillars in their kingdom of diarrhea people. And, you know, this is what conservatism is. And liberals are the ones who actually are capable of caring about people they've never met. Conservatives, at this point, generally, it's got to happen to you or someone you know before you care.
Right,
and believe me, Tucker's fall is going to be beautiful. Tucker's fall is going to be like Bill O'Reilly's fall, but at Burning Man. It's going to be sparkly and shiny and fireworks. It's going to be amazing.
No, and thank you for reminding us, because we're mostly focused on what a horrible racist he is now. We forgot about what a horrible homophobe and misogynist he's also always been.
Listen to the Bubba the Love Sponge tapes. Listen, he looks like someone like just built a Build-A-Bear out of human parts. I mean, let's be honest. This is Tucker, this lipless, every night watching his chin fuse into his neck. This doughy grimace, this crypto-fascist scowl of his. We are going to be here when Tucker is gone. And again, like, this is the whole game, right? They don't care how many Americans they kill.
I talked to him in person when you and I were at Politicon. Oh. I'm talking to some people and he shows up. I was like, oh God.
Yeah.
It's just, okay. But that's what I mean. When people are dying, it just is on the, it is not free speech to me. And then aren't they even arguing that in a lawsuit that they're defending him? It's like, oh, well, no one could expect to believe him. Well, the millions of people he's preaching to do.
Yeah, but that lawsuit's incredible because and it is over. It was thrown out, but it was actually a really powerful case, and it was the Susan McDougal case.
Yeah.
And Fox News won by persuasively arguing, and this is true, that no reasonable viewer can take Tucker Carlson seriously. This was here in New York. Yeah. The lawsuit was dismissed because Karen McDougal filed a defamation suit against Fox because Tucker slandered her, and the network tried to dismiss the case arguing, this is Fox saying, Carlson's statements were not statements of fact, and she failed to adequately allege actual malice. And the judge agreed that any reasonable viewer arrives with an appropriate amount of skepticism about things Tucker Carlson says. Literally, how could you be so dumb as to believe this man? Case dismissed.
Yeah.
So,
well, it's what they're trying to argue with.
Bosses argue he's a liar.
It's what Sidney Powell and their defense is literally, oh, it was just her opinion that the election was stolen. No, that's not what she said. She said, it's not my opinion. I have all this proof. And there's
Giuliani as well.
What's that?
Giuliani as well. Giuliani would give press conferences and say there was voter fraud and then walk right into the courthouse and tell the judge there was no voter fraud.
Yeah.
I mean, they just do it for the cameras.
Yeah.
That's how Ratcliffe got to be in charge of national security. They posture for the cameras for the folks watching Fox and to appease the audience of one. And then they go and sow destruction because they're all fundamentally incompetent. And believe me, there's got to be a reckoning on this, both in terms of when we as a culture are going to stand up to Fox News and the disinformation and lies, the way we finally, after decades, stood up to the cigarette companies.
Yeah.
It's going to be the same thing, and it's going to be a class action lawsuit.
Yeah.
And, you know, I have a lot of faith in Merrick Garland. I really, really
so
do.
That's what Glenn Kirshner just told us today. Mm-hmm. So, let's try to be patient. Not my strong suit. Thank you, personal comedy Jesus. You're just better than most of us. You're more patient. You are personal comedy
you
Jesus.
You are.
Yes, you are.
That's true.
All right.
You're very, very kind. Thank you very much.
Love you, John Bugleson.
Thank you guys. And I'll be around next week and be well. And thank you. Thank you. Oh, and white power. White power.
Yeah.
White power.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Oh, what? No. Oh, huh? That,
no. No. That took a turn.
That one sucked.
I've got some Van Morrison. Sorry, I've been listening to this new 28-track Van Morrison album for 2 days. And I'm just, oh, my God. It's like watching your beloved elderly loved ones die. It's
all right. Or
turn evil first.
Oh, dear. Okay. Goodbye now.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
All right.